Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and I want to talk about gun control again, and not necessarily the entire topic, but just one specific argument that people who support gun control or some measures of gun control use. And it's, I don't know why they use it. It's, in my opinion, it's the weakest argument, and if that's not the case, it's definitely the most, I don't know, it's a stupid argument, and it's my least favorite argument that, you know, gun control advocates use. And it's an argument that kind of, it says that Second Amendment in regards to having a militia or having people who would be able to oppose the government in case government turns tyrannical. It says that this part of Second Amendment is kind of archaic, kind of pointless. And it says this, the argument kind of goes like, well, you know, you can have all the guns you want, but how are you going to fight against a government who has jets, drones, all the assault rifles and mortars and tanks and such? This is pointless that if you want to stock up your weapons to fight against a government who is so much more powerful than you. That is really one of the arguments, and I can't believe it's used so much even now, even by logical people. It's a really, really awful argument, because it asks us to just give up to a government. If a government is indeed tyrannical, if President Obama suddenly decides that he wants to become the king of the United States of America, and he wants to impose his will on us, and Congress agrees and becomes his prime ministers in this royal court, and Supreme Court says this is now constitutional, what happens when the United States government turns tyrannical, turns into a monarchy, turns into a totalitarian government? Well, this argument says, well, okay, tough shit, we don't really have a choice because we can't fight against it, because what are we to do? We only have these pistols and hunting rifles. Horrible argument. Really? That's what you're suggesting, that we just give up? That Second Amendment doesn't matter? Because we have no way of resisting. So that's the biggest problem I see with it is just what the message is. The ultimate message is that you shouldn't resist a government, that you should just let it go. The point of having weapons, even though the government may be extremely more powerful than us, people in government are still human beings. You know, they're not Superman, they're not Hulk. They are still human beings. And that's not to say every part of government agrees with each other. If President Obama does become tyrannical, let's just say this is a totally imaginary scenario, I'm not saying this will happen, and I'm pretty confident that this will not happen ever at all. But let's say that President Obama somehow makes it so that he decides to become the king of the United States. Then ultimately, what could possibly happen is the country goes along with it, or the country revolts, or even parts of his government may revolt. There might be a coup d'etat. You know, the military might not agree. Maybe the Air Force says, yeah, we want Obama to be our king, but then maybe the Navy and the National Reserve and the Coast Guard and such see that and like, oh no, we can't do this. And the general of those kind of forces disagree. Well, then we have a civil war on our hands. And in this civil war, it is extremely important that the citizens of, you know, these former groups who used to be one country are armed. Because if we are not armed, then there is no resistance. There is absolutely no resistance at all. And government can become tyrannical, and we have no choice but to allow that to happen. But if the populace is armed, at least the government has a fear of an armed resistance. We might lose. The tyrannical government might end up winning ultimately, and United States of America may ultimately become a totally tyrannical government, something like Nazi Germany. You know, there were French resistance groups, but they were so weak and so few that, you know, Nazi Europe was pretty much in total control. That could possibly happen. But we shouldn't just allow it to happen. We should always fight against it. and what allows us at all times to be able to fight it when we least expect it is to be prepared, with an armed populace. If everyone, not everyone, but if enough people who believe that the greatest government is a government that accepts dissent, that accepts opinions of its citizens, that is for democratic republic. If this populace believes in such ideals and love his country and have their own moral systems, they don't want their governments to turn tyrannical. If these people were armed, and if there are a lot of these kinds of people, then even when governments decides to turn into a totalitarian state, well, maybe they'll win, but there's certainly a good chance that they could also lose. And that's the message of the Second Amendment. That's the important thing about Second Amendment. Maybe we'll lose, but who's to say that we will? If you disregard Second Amendment altogether, then there's only one possibility, and is that it will lose to a totalitarian government. And that's not a good thing at all. So those are my thoughts on that. Really, I think it's a really stupid argument to be using if you're for gun control. There are certainly other arguments that gun control people use, and some of them I find sensible, but this one, not so. Those are my thoughts. Tell me your thoughts and share your comments. Hope you enjoyed. Cheers.